Hey, how are you doing? Beast Bowie, bro. Congratulations. Yeah, congratulations.
I admire you. I really do. I'm so happy to have met you. Okay, you're like the most inspirational person for me. Right, I would love to become your student.
My heart in your
mouth. I'm chuffed. It's like I'm seeing my idol here.
Oh, wow.
I know that's not the right word to use, but honestly, I have the most upper respect for you.
I
wish I could have your knowledge. I wish I had your wisdom and everything. I really do. I admire you. I'm the biggest fan.
Not me, but Christ in you, bro. Not me, but anything good in me that you see is Christ.
I see you as one of the most intellectual person, and I love how you deliver it.
Yeah.
And that's why I admire you so much.
Well, I mean, bro, I'd be happy to, if you want, you could join a discipleship class that I run.
I would be honoured.
Then I'll give you my email address, drop us an email, and I'll add you to the discipleship.
I'll be honoured. That would make you the happiest man alive.
But what I would say to you is that, I really do appreciate the love, you know, but anything good that you see in me is simply the work of God, you know, and if there's anything good in me, it's because it reflects Jesus our Savior.
But the reason I appreciate you so much is because you're a great representative of God and the words of God, and that's why I really admire you.
Okay, I want to stress to you though, I'm a sinner just like you.
Bro. No.
I have my struggles.
Far from that.
I sin just like you do.
Far from it. I'm sure you make everyone, you know, as long as people listen to you, they, as I do, will bring you closer to God.
Yeah.
And that's why you took me closer to God, and that's why I really, really admire you.
Thanks be to God. Thanks be to God. I'm glad that the Holy Spirit has done something good through what I'm doing.
No, honestly, bless you. Yeah. Bless you.
Were you just became a Christian how long ago?
Recently, to be honest with you, I've not just taken on Christ. I believe Christ has taken me on.
Very true.
So, you know, I'm still new to it, but I'm a strong believer.
And I know
the truth is with Yeshua HaMashiach.
Amen.
And I'm still a beginner, but I want to learn all the knowledge, especially from you.
Well, a good place to watch is obviously to watch Soko Films.
I have. I'm watching you closely.
That's one of the best places. And then, you know, I've got my own channel, right?
I have. James has told me about that.
Bob the Builder, Soko Films. If you link onto there. And the thing is, like, we as Christians, we've got to rediscover a muscular Christianity, the kind of wimpy Christianity that is. Like, there's been a big pushback amongst the Christians here at the corner. They've rallied. The Muslims aren't dominating the conversations as much as they used to.
I don't want to just do it as a theory, but I want to, as a practice.
Amen. Then what you should read? You should read what C.S. Lewis said about. Read C.S. Lewis' essay, Men Without Chests. Yeah, and you also need to read what S.A. Lewis talked about when he talked about a Christian knight. Because the idea of a Christian knight is what I seek to emulate. In the modern context, of course, I'm not running around with armor and sword and chopping people. Like, not doing that. But it's the idea that a Christian man has to be that perfect balance between being a savage, brutal warrior on one side and a gentle courtier on the other, who cultivates his sense of aesthetics, his sense, his knowledge, his sense of refinement, that he is gentle with the weak, that he is merciful to the dispossessed, that he is someone, he's a gentlemanly warrior. That is the idea that every Christian man should seek to emulate.
I would
the curtain not far off that anyway.
Bless you, God bless you.
Because they're already natural warriors.
To have that recognition, yeah. You know, I would really appreciate
the
that.
The curds are natural warriors.
And I want nothing more than to be a warrior of God.
Amen. Peace be with you, bro. God real pleasure you. To meet you. I'd love to hear your story, but maybe, I don't know if you want to tell it on camera or off camera.
I'm still new to this. I'll take it slow, my pace. But I'm still, you know, seeking knowledge. I'm not really prepared,
yeah.
You know, to spread the word.
Yeah.
But hopefully, all in due time, with your teachings, I shall be representing Christianity through you as well.
I'm going to be doing a couple of talks later, so you're more than welcome to listen to those. This brother's got my email address, so get his email off of him. Contact me. I'll add you to the discipleship group, and you can join in a discipleship. All right, peace be with you, bro. Really good. Welcome to the family.
Thank you.
Another, yet another Kurdish Christian, one of a movement amongst the Kurds. The Kurds are abandoning that Arab imposition known as Islam, and they're freeing themselves to be Kurds again.
We're going back to the roots.
Amen.
Amen.
Our history. Yeah, he's a Christian.
Because our history have all been.
Yeah. He was from Islam. I'm guessing he was from Islam.
Well, you know, Islam has made us. The Kurds are Islamic by force.
Yeah, I know.
So you know, it's not a choice that we had.
Yeah.
You know, we've been oppressed and by force we've had not an option to be.
Are you listening, liberal progressives? Carry on, bro.
The truth is the truth.
No. The Kurds were oppressed. Islam was by force.
It's not a choice. Kurds are actually one of the only people that didn't openly convert. They fought the battle, but we lost the battle because of the influence around us.
Yeah.
You can imagine we've got neighbors from hell, or neighbors that nobody on earth could wish for. We've got Turkey being the main problem, and we've got Iraq, Syria, Iran. You know, to say the least. But that's all I'm going to say for now. But
we need a Kurdish homeland.
Indeed, we do.
We need a Kurdish homeland.
God bless.
We need a Kurdish homeland. The Kurdish people have sided with the West consistently in modern times. They fought against the enemies of the West, and it's time that the West now back the Kurds to have a land of their own. Because the Kurds are throwing off this Arab imposition known as Islam, and they're embracing, increasingly, they're embracing the Christian faith. We know that there are problems currently within the Kurdish area, particularly in their treatment of Assyrian Christians. But if the Kurds embrace Christ, those problems with their Christian brothers and sisters will reconcile. And we've got to support the Kurdish movement for independence, as well as upholding the freedom of the Assyrian Christians to have a land of their own as well in Nineveh. But the Kurdish people need a homeland, and we've got to stand up to Turkey and its oppression of Kurdish people. Otherwise, we might watch what happened to the Armenian Christians and the Syrian Christians and the Greek Christians happen to the Kurds. And we don't right one injustice by creating another injustice. The Turks have to be brought to heel. The Turkish state has to be brought to heel. Boycott Turkey because of its many crimes, not least its crimes against the Kurdish people. And I would say to you, if you are a Kurd, consider your history. Consider how Muslim Arabs oppressed you. Consider how Muslim Turks oppressed you. Consider how Muslim Iranians oppressed you. And ask yourself, is this Arab imposition something that you want to follow? What has it brought to your people? Abandon this Arabization, abandon this foreign god that has been foisted upon you by empires of old. The Iranian people are rediscovering what it means to be Iranian, to rediscover their Persian culture by abandoning Islam. The Kurds need to do the same. Abandon Islam and embrace the Christian faith. Because the Christian faith means that you become truly Kurdish. It takes all that is Kurdish, all that is good about your culture, and it celebrates it in the confederacy of the church. It doesn't say that you have to become an Arab. Christianity allows each nationality to become the best of itself. Islam, by comparison, is always accompanied by Arabization. If you don't believe me, look at Zaki Alaya, the Jamaican convert to Islam, who now walks around the park trying his best to speak Arabic, dressed like an Arab, using an Arab name, bowing to an Arab city. Think of Hamza just last week. An English convert dresses like an Arab, tries to use Arabic in discussion, even when talking to another Englishman. Islam is equal to Arabization. Christianity is about the best of your nationality going forward into the church. Every Kurd has a choice. This brother made that choice. He chose to follow Jesus Christ. Every Kurd can do the same. You don't have to follow Muhammad's Arab religion.